Hi Tech Checkers, welcome to another episode of Tech Checkers channel, and today we talk about what is object-oriented programming and why should you care? You get this question in interviews a lot of times, and there's a basic simple answer to that. The concepts are abstraction, polymorphism, inheritance, and encapsulation. So it's a pie. In the past, before object-oriented programming, there was already procedural programming. That is what I learned when I was young. And procedural or functional programming languages were based on functions. So there were a lot of functions flowing around, and there was variables like data, and these functions were manipulating the data. And most of the time, a lot of those variables were even global available, so that the more the program was growing, the more variables were flying around, and it got more and more confusing. Especially in the hardware industry, there's still a lot of C programming languages. They struggle a lot with trying to organize this source code that they use. Usually there's always an initialization function that, for example, in a computer game, would initialize the direct so the graphics card, it would initialize the audio, every video technology that is used for playing videos. The keyboard, mouse, display everything on the screen. It is very straightforward, but as I said, it could become very complex when there's a lot of code. That's why people invented object-oriented programming languages to encapsulate all this complexity and make it simpler with these four concepts that we were talking about in the beginning. What object-oriented programming really does, that it encapsulates all these functions and the variables in one container. In this small tiny universe, this container could survive everywhere else. You could just grab it and put it somewhere else. The variables in this container are called properties, and the functions are called methods that manipulate this object. Just like in a computer game where you have a swordsman that can fight, he can die, spawn, run around. You can use this object in other games as well and reuse it. Even in real life, we also have a lot of these blueprints. A head, two arms, you can walk, sleep, eat, run around, and of course learn and watch YouTube videos. And if you write all these on paper, then we have a blueprint what our object of a human should be able to do. And this is called a class. This blueprint is called a class, and from this blueprint, you then can create a real human being. So templates are classes. When you then create a real entity, this is called an object. If you really can see the swordsman on the field in the computer game, and if there's no swordsman at all, and you just know you could create one, then this is a class. Now let's have a look at abstraction. Abstraction means basically that things get a lot easier when looking at them. If you have a smartphone, like this one for example, then it looks very simple. You don't know what's going on inside, even though there's a lot of hardware. It's super tricky to build. And even all these programming things, the software that is inside of the smartphone is super complex. It takes tens of years to make. But you can just switch it on and use the whole smartphone. And this making it simple strategy, this is called abstraction. And in programming, that means that you can hide certain functions or certain data variables or properties so that they are private members. For example, you could make a function that says attack, then your soldier attacks some other soldier. And your colleague programmer, he can just use attack, which is super simple. He doesn't have to care about how exactly this attacking is going on. This abstraction makes life of programming a lot easier. We could even change some of the internal functions later when we, for example, want to optimize the code so that it is faster, and it will still work. Polymorphism means that you can use the same code base and change small parts of it and then make it reusable more often. So for example, we have a soldier, and this soldier can be a swordsman or a spearman. A swordsman has a sword, a spearman has a spear. Basically have the same function, they can attack and everything, but they look different. So the display function would be different. And therefore we can just say the spearman inherits the soldier class, and the swordsman also is part of the soldier class, and both just override the display function. Inheritance means that classes can inherit functions from other classes. They can actually inherit the whole other class. Usually you have a more general class like soldier, and then you have a swordsman and a spearman, for example, and they can also, both of them can use the soldier function like walk, attack, run around, die. And this inheritance makes it easy because then you have one base class and you don't have to rewrite the code for the two subclasses. Summary: we have abstraction, which reduces the complexity and makes changes afterwards easier. Polymorphism: having multiple forms of a single object is called polymorphism. Different objects can respond to the same message in different ways. For example, it can be displayed as a soldier that has a spear or a soldier that has a sword. Inheritance means that an object can copy functions and data from another class so that you don't have to rewrite it again. Encapsulation makes code easier to write and read and to reuse. Your homework today is, for one thing, remember a pie. And the other thing is, just think about one object that is sitting around you and think about what kind of functions could this object have. For example, this one is a glass of water. It has a percentage, how much filling it has. Then it has a material, it's a 3D object. The methods that it has is break. It can get filled and it can get emptied. See you next time. Maybe next time we will do some other videos about Unity 3D programming language tutorial. Because with Unity you can make awesome simulations and games. And I want to really show you how this goes, how this works. Because I mean, you can do so much stuff. You can do virtual reality simulations, or you can earn a lot of money. You can do machine learning with Unity. If you're interested, then like this video to support the YouTube algorithm and subscribe. Thank you. See you next time. Your Tech Checker.